Guess those are astronauts. I don't know why I put them in. What I was trying to do is create an eco house, something really quick and fast for a meeting. It's not the best house in the world, but it gives you some insight into how to use SketchUp really quickly and then render it in Kirkathea. So here's a quick overview of how to build an eco house. So let's start making our eco house. I just decided it should be an 800 square foot house, so I'm going to go a 20 foot by 40 foot house. So here's my slab. It's going to be on a slab. I'm going to make it 8 inches high. And then I'm going to offset the walls 8 inches. So I'm going to make the exterior walls 8 inches thick. And then I'm going to just draw some guidelines here. Let's see. I want the first room to be 10 feet. And then I can put a wall in there, 6-inch wall. I'm using 6-inch walls. Typically, they'd probably be 5 inches, but let's try a 6-inch wall. And the next room, I want to make it 12 feet. And I'm going to make this wall 6 inches as well. And then I need a bathroom. So those are going to be the two bedrooms. A bathroom, let's say 8 feet. And then I need a wall there too. Oops. Got to make sure you hit a little X. And you just have to hit 6 because it already knows the length. And then I'm going to just say, well, what do I want here? The width is 18.8. Well, I'm just going to go 18 feet. No, 9 feet. Let's go 9 feet. And then create another wall. 6 inches. All right. Well, I don't want all of these walls, so I can start getting rid of some things. Don't need that. Don't need that. Don't need these. Oops. Just hit Control Z. I seem to be the king of Control Z. But let's get rid of some of this stuff. You don't have to do it this way, but it just makes the walls a little simpler. I don't want that one. Don't want that one. Undo that. Sometimes you get a little too crazy with this stuff. And there. And there. All right. This is my little frame, and I'm just going to grab it and go up 8 feet. I'm going to say the walls are 8 feet, and then I'd have the rafters on top of that. All right, let's get started. Well, first thing I want is a bathroom, and I haven't grouped anything. I'm in a hurry, right? I want to make this fast, so let's get some models. Let's go with the bathroom. And this one by SketchUp is pretty good. You can pick any ones you want. I'm just going to pick this one because they did a pretty good job of it. Stick it in the corner. Got a bathroom, and I picked the right 8 feet. Cool. And it also gives me a square that I can work with, a little corner here, so I can put in a corner. And I can bring it up. Make this a little utility closet. We can put electrical in there. We can put the water heater. We can put a whole bunch of stuff in the bathroom. Maybe a little storage space for some things. Okay. What else do I need? I need a kitchen. Let's go to the warehouse. Not stealing anything, just using it for demo purposes. This is just a concept house. All right? You're in a bit of a hurry. You got to show something in a meeting. I think this one is kind of interesting. Let's put it over here. And just go into the group and get rid of a few things. I don't need all of that or that. Let's see what I got here. I just want to make it square and smaller. That's not bad. So now I just have to rotate it 90 degrees and then move it over to the corner. Move. Not too bad. I mean, you can play with kitchens. It's in there. Now I've got this desk here or a kitchen table. I'm going to go into the system, grab it, and just move it. Put it in this corner. I don't know what the best orientation for this thing would be, but something like that, maybe. Don't let it go through the wall. little more room. So now I've got a little nook. That was lucky. All right. Kitchen nook. Well, I can't have a wall here, can we? No, we cannot. So let's just grab something, and I'm just eyeballing it because it's concept house. All right. A little arc. Something like that. Delete that. Push it through. Grab the other side, and it's gone. So there's our house. We've got a couple bedrooms and a kitchen. Well, obviously we need to paint some of it, so let's get the colors. I'm going to go with a wood floor. Let's see what I got here. Wood floor. Now, see, I'm going to undo that. I left a little line, and that's why it broke the rooms up. And you can do that, and you can have tile or something in the kitchen, but we're in a hurry. So there's that. I want carpet, I don't know, in the bedrooms. I want some color. I don't care, red. Right? I don't know, what color would go in the other room? Not orange, it's too... Well, I got yellow up, so I like yellow in a kitchen. Now you can see there's some mistakes in the kitchen, this piece here, but let's just leave that and say that that's where we're going to put electrical and stuff behind that for the kitchen. And we're in a bit of a hurry, so we're not going to touch any of that. And the bathroom, I'm zooming around. I hope you guys are not getting a headache with this. Go a little slower. Maybe some tile. Black's not my favorite, but I can just change the color a little bit. Oh, that's really awful, but you get the idea. You can change colors, you can edit it, do anything you want. And then I can put a little line in here. Zoom in right on the corner, bring it up, and I can grab this tile and put it in the shower. All right, got a shower curtain, got a shower bathroom, not too bad. All right, I need a color for this. What color would I make it? Definitely feeling greenish, something subtle maybe. Goes with the carpet. And then, of course, gotta make something purple. I don't know why, but there you go, purple. So there's a little box, all right? So here's something I wanna do. I wanna bring this up 2 inches, and then I'm going to draw, oops, let's grab it right in the corner. It's not going to do it. I'll show you why I'm doing this. 2 inches. I just wanted a line there. So what am I going to do? I'm going to put some siding on the house. Let's see. Brick and cladding. I'm going to use this siding here. And I want a little bit of the concrete pad showing, right? The grass, you know, you have to have a little bit of the concrete for the water flow. So I've got everything. Oh, I don't have that wall in there. Select that. A little yellow, yellow. I think I got everything. So here's my little house. All right, now what? Well, I'll get rid of that. I've got some components that I made, and I made another video where I showed you how to make 2 cutting planes. So what does that do for you? Well, let's grab the door. I made this door. And I'm going to say it comes up to there. Where do I want to put it? I want to put it here. Then you can right-click on it and go explode. And it cuts the 2 planes on the 8-inch wall. So I had that pre-made in my little component library. Now I can do the same sort of thing with my windows. And I could put them a certain height. I'm just going to eyeball it and say there. And then I'm going to copy maybe a pair of windows here. Of course, I need a couple in the kitchen area. Need some windows in the end of the bedroom. And I'm not worried about the height. I probably should be. But you could draw a line so that when you're clicking on it, it will be perfect. Lots of windows. I like windows. So let's put some here. I don't know. Too close together. I think that's kind of architectural. And then one in the corner. All right, so I've got all my windows. So I can go now to this, select instances, and they're all selected. And I can go explode. And I made two cutting planes on these, so they're all set. All right? You can see through everything. I better do a control S. I had a bug splat earlier, and that's annoying. So I don't have any color in the bathroom. Let's fix that. I don't know. Since I started with blue, let's continue on with blue. All right. Well, my house is coming along. But you're saying there's no doors to the bedroom, and you're right. So I need to go to my components again. And I made some doors a long time ago. Or did I? Oh, I didn't make any doors. Or did I? Let's try. I have some doors, but I don't know if it's going to work. Doesn't seem to want to work. Now, this is a bit of a bummer. So, I'll have to do it the old-fashioned way. My component doors don't seem to want to work. Well, let's just grab one then. 3D warehouse, get model, door, frame. Here's a good one. All right. I'm going to rotate it. And then I'm going to copy it. And I'm going to scale it this way, minus one. So I just made a backup copy of it because, and I'll show you here in a minute. Let's just copy it over. I'll just leave these here. You hold your control key down, grab the bottom. Well, I need a door that kind of opens into the room in the corner like that. And then I need a door. Well, I need a door. What do I want? Do I want it to have them back to back like that so it sort of swings in this way? I could do that. And then I need a bathroom door. So let's go and put them in here. So the bathroom door is somewhere in the corner like that. So you can see they're not really doors until I do something. So let's go down. And hopefully when I push through, I got rid of some of the wall. Perfect. Except you can see this door is not correct because it's kind of opening outwards. So I've got these backwards, but we're not going to tell anybody because we're in a hurry. Maybe that's the style we want. Probably not, right? But in a hurry. All right. So I can get rid of these two doors. I'm going to do a control S just to save it. I'm going to delete my guidelines. Now I can put a roof on this. Now look down here, there's something there. A door came in there. I don't want that. Those are my doors. I don't know why that component worked that way. There we go. Got rid of them. So what I would do is I'd probably put something down like this. Reverse the face. Maybe put some vegetation down, some grass. I'd turn on the sun. And I'd kind of look at it like that. Now I could put a roof on it. There's trusses you can get from the internet. But let me just show you what you can do really quick. Now you can take this and export it to a program like Kirkathea. And let's just call it house. Yes, we'll replace it. And it should open with the model. But again, I've screwed mine up. So I'll just do that. And so here's the model. So I'm going to grab that vegetation. I'm going to apply. I've got some grass. I have to get the bitmap coordinates because the grass is not quite right. It's too small, so I'll pump that up. Sounds good. Turn that off. Click on the windows. Make transparent glass. Click on the door windows. I think I can do that. Transparent thin glass. Put in some kind of global. So that's the sky. Right? I can make the paint a little more shiny. I'll just do the purple and you can see the difference. And then I can insert, let's just insert something really quick, like a shrub. And I've got a shrub now in the corner. And you can instance it, meaning you can put more of them in. And I'm going to use the grass as the canvas. And I'm going to say distance is nothing. I'm going to say normal, change it around. I'm going really fast, but at a lot of population. So what I'm doing is I'm just kind of creating shrubbery. And I didn't want normal, actually. Let's change that because it's making everything crazy. I want roll. I want them to rotate a little bit. So I can make some shrubberies. All right. Just so it sort of looks like there's some shrubs and things. And I can start rendering this. See what it looks like. I need to zoom in a little bit on it. So let's do that. Too far away, makes it look funny. Right, get a good angle of it. Try it now. All right, it's processing. So the problem, though, I go, well, let's take a look. My computer gets pretty frozen when this sort of thing works. I don't know if I'm going to be able to record while it does it. Not looking too bad. Let's stop it. I'm going to be surprised if I can actually get this thing to work. Let's just do this. Start render and let's use two cores so I can keep two cores running for everything else. All right, it's running, but I sort of made a mistake. I don't really have much going on in here. I need to have a path. So I'm just going to draw something really quick. And put some bricks down. How about that's not the greatest path. but that's not bad. So what I can do is I can just grab this, right? And I can export that, and I'll just call it walk. And now I can go back to this model, and we can take a quick look at it. How is it looking? It's not bad. It's quick. You know, I can add materials. The red doesn't work very well, so let's stop it. Let's get rid of this. Let's get rid of the red here. Come on. Red. Let's make it... I don't know, what kind of wood would we have on this? Not planks. Some golden pine. All right, I'm going to make golden pine frames. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to merge. Add and merge. All right, here we go. I'm going to merge that walk because it will add, and now I can do this and render it, and I can zoom out a little bit. It's too much. Big screen. So it's working on it. Since I only have two cores of my quad core processor working, it's a little slow. I could change the front door wood to something a little bit more dramatic. I could change the siding. I could show everything. I can rotate it and show the different bathroom views. But you can see how quick it is. And in the beginning of this video, you can see what I did with more like a half an hour of rendering. That came out kind of frog-like, didn't it? Anyways, a quick video, how to make a house in, I don't know, how long is this video? 20 minutes? Something you can show your bosses, something you can show the different sizes. And then, let's stop this. I want to quit. Yes, please. Go back to this. You know, we didn't even talk about things in the house. We can go and we can add a couch. Things to make it more realistic and things to make it more of a home. Right. Obviously, you wouldn't put it right in the middle of the room, but maybe by the doorway here. It's just a small little house. Right? Maybe every TV over here. But it gives you an idea of how to do things quick. Make a little house, make a little presentation, and then render it. So give it a try and see how it goes.